Hey everyone, Jason Schaffert here of MzeroA.com, and we're launching a new series now. This month, we're diving into and talking about aviation weather. It's kind of that time of year. Summer is coming, summer thunderstorms are coming here. We're gonna be dealing with this more and more. So today, we're talking about thunderstorm flying, and I wanna start with a story. About an hour before takeoff, the pilot obtained an updated weather briefing, which included a discussion about thunderstorm activity along the route of flight. About 2 hours, 30 minutes after takeoff, the pilot was deviated around thunderstorm activity when the airplane disappeared from radar. A witness near the accident heard the aircraft revving up and down, and then a muffled pop, and then silence, before seeing debris falling from the sky, well above the tree line. Examination of the airplane revealed that it experienced an in-flight breakup. However, no evidence of a mechanical malfunction was identified. Weather radar images indicated the airplane entered a developing area of moderate to heavy intensity echoes consistent with a convective cell or thunderstorm. The pilot advised air traffic control he was receiving weather information through a portable GPS receiver with a weather subscription service. There were no published convective segments at the time, that's interesting to me, or center weather advisories for thunderstorms current at the time of the accident for the area encompassing the accident site. The pilot received his airplane multi-engine rating on May 13, 2006. As of June 18, 2006, the pilot had accumulated 1,720 hours of total flight experience, which included 32 hours in multi-engine airplanes, 26 accumulated in the accident airplane. In addition, the pilot had logged about 140 hours and 68 hours of actual and simulated instrument time, respectively. Except for 0.4 hours of simulated flight time logged during his multi-engine check ride, the pilot had not logged any additional instrument flight experience in multi-engine airplanes. Review of the airplane's ground speed revealed that the ground speed remained between 190 and 200 miles per hour during most of the cruise portion of the flight. At approximately 12:47, the airplane gained 60 miles per hour in ground speed over the course of the next 35 seconds. The airplane descended 1,200 feet during this time frame for an average descent rate of approximately 2,100 feet per minute. The airplane's ground speed stabilized for the next 8 seconds, while the airplane descended at an average rate of 9,000 feet per minute. At 12:48, the airplane's ground speed began increasing again to 471 miles per hour. The last recorded GPS target was at 12:48 at an altitude of 4,123 feet with an average descent rate of 6,000 feet per minute. The NTSB's probable cause? The pilot's inadvertent encounter with a thunderstorm, which resulted in loss of control and a subsequent in-flight breakup. I hate talking about accidents, especially ones like this, but I chose this NTSB report to illustrate. There were no convective segments. At the time, you saw the weather radar and you might be thinking, wow, I have screenshots of me on FlightAware and I've been near storms that look just like this. And this is why it's so important to understand thunderstorms and how thunderstorms actually develop as well. You see, you need to understand not just for a private pilot check ride or an instrument pilot check ride, we need to know the ingredients that make up a thunderstorm. What do we need? We need unstable air. We need an uplifting action, and then we need excess moisture. This is why summer storms are so prevalent. It's unstable. We get the uplifting action, the uneven heating of the Earth's surface, and then the dissipation of that heat. And then it's humid just about wherever you go, unless you're flying out in Arizona per se. Deal with that humidity. The humidity is excess moisture in the air. So in a case like Florida, where we fly, this is how we get those afternoon thunderstorms. Now, our thunderstorms go through three stages. They are the cumulus stage, which is depicted as the building phase. This is the nasty updrafts and can often lead to some downdrafts in these towering cumulonimbus clouds as well. In our accident, it looks like he may have encountered a thunderstorm that was in the cumulus stage, building, albeit very rapidly though, and possibly some microbursts associated with that as well. We then enter into the mature stage at the start of rainfall. The moment rain falls, the mature stage of the thunderstorm has begun. And then lastly, the dissipating stage. This is where the thunderstorm begins to rain itself out. Have you ever been caught in a storm where it's raining, and all of a sudden, everything breaks loose? The rain increases, you know, tenfold. The size of the droplets double. That's the dissipating stage. It can no longer hold that moisture up, and it's dissipating that storm all the way out. What does the FAA have to say about thunderstorm flying? For this, we can actually go to the AIM, where I'm going to call them thunderstorm rules. We know that in the AIM is just helpful suggestions, but if we all acted like they are rules, we'd be safer, smarter pilots as well. So I'm going to call them thunderstorm rules, even though they come from the AIM. Never go closer than 5 miles to any visible storm cloud with an overhanging area, and strongly consider increasing that distance to 20 miles or more. You can encounter hail and violent turbulence anywhere within 20 miles of very strong thunderstorms. Our next rule, and some of these come from the AIM, some of these come from advisory circulars as well on thunderstorm flying. Do not attempt flight beneath thunderstorms, even when visibility is good, because of the destructive potential of sheer turbulence in these areas. Think back to the story we opened with here. Can you see how this rule applies? At the first sign of turbulence, reduce airspeed immediately to the manufacturer's recommended airspeed for turbulent air penetration for a specific gross weight. That could be your maneuvering speed, or VA. Remember, that's why they specify a gross weight, because maneuvering speed changes with weight. Our next rule. If the aircraft inadvertently penetrates a thunderstorm, maintain a straight and level attitude on a heading that will take you through the storm in the shortest time. So often we think, oh, I'll make the 180-degree turn, I'll get back out of here. And that can work VFR into IMC into a nice stable stratus layer. But if you start getting nasty updrafts and downdrafts, the best thing you can do is straight and level and hold that. Don't worry about much anything else. Don't worry about your altitude. Keep within range, within reason. But you try to make a turn out of there, you could really be testing the structural integrity of your aircraft. Obviously, we don't want to end up in that situation. That's why I want to leave you with this. Never let compulsion take the place of good judgment. You never have to be anywhere in aviation. And if you do, you need to have a backup plan to airline, to drive, whatever it may be. But don't let compulsion, the need to be there, take the place of good judgment. This is why we have the commercial pilot certificate. People always say, why can't private pilots fly for compensation or higher? Because when you start to fly for compensation or higher, it adds such a unique pressure. The pressure to, you know, I gotta pay the bills. The pressure to the boss is asking me to be there. I'm flying this VIP, whatever it is, they're expecting me to be there. That's why we have the commercial pilot certificate, just to alleviate some of that pressure, to add experience to it. We can't let compulsion take the place of good judgment. Thunderstorm flying. I can't wait to read your comments below this video. And listen, I hope you'll be joining us for our Aviation Mastery at Sea. Perhaps you've already heard us talking about it here. It's October 26th through the 31st. My good friend Steve-O-1 Knievo will be joining us here as well. It's 5 days on the cruise with the entire MzeroA.com family, some just passionate people about aviation, all working towards making you a safer, smarter pilot. Family-friendly event as well. So we'll be launching our brand new co-pilot course as well. And your co-pilots, your non-flying spouses or friends, your co-pilots, can take their own track as well. While you're learning about the latest in aviation technology, they can be on the co-pilot track as well, learning how to be an asset in the cockpit, how to work as a team, and really exercise proper crew resource management. aviationmastery.com if you wish to learn more about that and reserve one of our cabins. We have a limited amount. We want to keep this a very special event as well. So check that out. Can't wait to read your comments. Can't wait to see you in October on the Aviation Mastery at Sea as well. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya. Take a 2-week free trial of our online ground school and see why Aviation Consumer Magazine named it the top online ground school on the market. The first thing you'll notice is that we never teach to the test. We teach real world skills that are going to keep you and your loved ones safe when you fly. Now, it's because of this real world teaching, you'll pass your knowledge test and your check ride with flying colors. With one membership, you get access to all our courses, plus weekly webinars with myself and this outstanding MzeroA.com team. It's really like an interactive TV show broadcast from our studio, where you get to interact with a team of CFIs. We also offer live support and email support to make sure you succeed. Now, one thing you'll notice is that MzeroA is like nothing else on the market. It is truly a flight training community geared towards making you a safer, smarter pilot, because a good pilot is always learning. It's much more than a slogan for us. It is truly a mission. So click below and take a 2-week, no strings attached trial of our top rated private, instrument, commercial, and FOI courses. Once you join our flight training community, I promise you will never want to leave.